Hi friends, welcome back to Star Laboratory. If you are not a subscriber, first of all please subscribe the channel and don't forget to press the bell button. Okay, today we are going to discuss about the topic on sperm count. Commonly the sperm counts is coming under the semen analysis. So when we are performing the semen analysis in the laboratory, it is a must to do the sperm count also. So when we are performing this semen analysis, normally we are considering in the two major categories. So first one is the macroscopic appearance, then the second one is the microscopic appearance. Here the macroscopic appearance can be visualized by the naked eye and we are reporting. So we should consider the appearance of the specimens, then the volume. So the volume also should be needed. Then the third one is the pH of the specimen. Then the fourth thing is the viscosity. Then fifth one is the liquefaction time. So these things are we should consider when we are performing the macroscopically. Then the sample should be charged into a counting chamber. Then we should visualize this microscopical appearance. So here we are doing the sperm count. Then the second thing is the morphology of the sperms. Then the third one is the motility of the sperms. Then the fourth thing is the WBC counts, that also very important. Then this RBC count also should be included in this microscopical appearance. Okay, now let's see one by one in details. So first, if we are considering the appearance of the specimen, so the specimen should be in a gray-white in color, translucent and a misty odor. Then the volume. So the volume should be nearly 2 milliliter to 5 milliliter in the range. Then the third thing is the pH. So the pH range should be in 7.2 to 8. So it should be a slightly alkaline. So here we are using litmus paper or pH papers to measure the pH. Then the fourth thing is the viscosity. Here the specimen is allowed to flow drop by drop and the viscosity is measured. Then the final thing is the liquefaction time. So the liquefaction time should be less than 30 minutes and ideally within 10 to 20 minutes. Okay, now let's go for the microscopy. So first one is the sperm count. So the sperm count should be greater than 20 million. Then the second one is the morphology. So the morphology of the sperm should be more than 30% in normal. Then the third thing is the motility. So this motility also should be greater than 50% in progressive. Then the fourth thing is the WBC. Though this WBC count in the sample should be less than 1 million per 1 milliliter. Then the final thing is the RBC count. Normally this RBC should not be available in this sample. Okay, now let's discuss about this sperm count. In the laboratories, we are performing the manual methods for this counting. So here we are using the counting chamber and a light microscope for this counting purpose. So this counting chamber, there are two types of counting chambers are available in the laboratories to perform this sperm count. So first one is the Makler counting chamber. This Makler counting chamber is a specially designed counting chamber for rapid and accurate sperm count. Here the motility also we can observe by using this counting chamber with this undiluted semen sample. So this Makler counting chamber, here we are not using any of the chemicals for this immobility of this specimen. Just we are directly observing the pure samples and we are observing the motility and doing the counting. Then the second type is the improved Newberg counting chamber. So this improved Newberg counting chamber is not specific for the sperm count. If the Makler counting chamber does not available in the laboratory, we can use this improved Newberg counting chamber for the sperm count. So here we have to use this formalin bicarbonate diluting fluid for this immobilization of the sperms, then doing the count. Then as an additional step, we can observe the clear morphology by doing the staining technique. Now let's see what are the importance of this semen analysis. So first one, to check the infertility and the subfertility. Then the second one, to access and monitor the effectiveness of the therapy, infertility and subfertility. Then third one, after vasectomy, to determine the successfulness of the operations. Okay, now let's do the counting with the help of this Makler counting chamber. First of all, let's see what are the requirements. First one, we need the Makler counting chamber for this counting. Here the semen sample also should be considered as a biological hazard, so therefore we need a biosafety cabinet and the personal protective equipments. Then we need a 37 degree Celsius incubator. After that we need a pressure pipette and the marker for this labeling. Then we need a good working light microscope. Then we need other related requirements. Okay, now let's move to the method. The sample should be collected into a wide mouth screw cap container. The container should be clean and dried, then it should be pre-warmed before the collection of the specimen. Then after the collection of the specimen should be labeled well and it should be sent along with the request form to the laboratory. After the sample collection, within 30 minutes we had to process the sample. So we should allow the sample for the liquefaction time. So after the liquefaction time, we should mix the sample well with the help of the pressure pipette. Then we charge the Makler counting chamber with the required amount. Then directly we observe the counting chamber under the light microscope. So that's all for today and thanks for watching. So after watching this video, please give a like, share it, subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell button. Thank you.